question of meditation. What is meditation? What does it look like? It looks like a lot of different things to a lot of different people. I had a very interesting conversation with a friend of mine when we were camping. I was talking about meditation and the value it had for me in my life. And he kind of balked at it. He's like, bah. I was like, so what's your ritual? What do you do? Like, you get up in the morning, what do you do? What happens? He's like, well, the first thing I do is I have a big window in my bedroom that looks out onto the woods. And so even before I get out of bed, because the bed like was in front of that window, he says, I roll over and I just spend like 10, 15 minutes just looking into the woods, seeing the birds, seeing what animals are out there. And I was like, okay, but you don't meditate. No, I don't meditate. I thought it was really funny because in a lot of ways what he was doing was meditating. That's what I would call it. You know, he obviously didn't see it that way. So meditation can be a lot of different things. For some people, even for myself, sometimes working with wood, if I'm working in the building something or carving something, working with my hands, and I can be doing it two ways. I could be like forcing the wood or the project into something. Or I can be working with the material to create something, two kind of different things. So if I'm making a drum, and I'm making the drum out of a log, I can when I'm carving on the log or shaping the log for the to receive the head or to embellish the body of the drum. I'm kind of working with the drum. I'm looking at the drum and holding the drum in my thoughts. And, look at this little interesting piece here. And doing something, sanding or carving to emphasize or to bring out a characteristic. So I'm kind of listening and responding to the material while I'm working. I'm not a knitter, but I'm sure somebody who knit would say that, if they're kind of in the flow of the knitting as opposed to being, more worried and frantic, if they were just kind of being with their knitting, I'm sure that could be very, very meditative. So there's a lot of different, cooking for me can be very meditative, kind of working with flavors, especially if something from the garden, something that I grew, it's bringing that food into the next level and, smelling the aromas and, sniffing different spices and seeing, that's good, that fits. And, it's that holding of a question. It's a holding of a question. So it can look a lot. It's in many different aspects of our life. And ultimately, the reason why we meditate is not to move away from the flow of our life and to seclude ourselves into this one little spot, this one little part of the house where, very ritualized. The point of all that, the point of meditation is not to go away and meditate. We go away to meditate, to practice. And what are we practicing? Well, we're practicing to build skill so that when we stand up, when we walk away from our cushion, we can carry our meditation with us. So the point about meditation is not about is not about this private thing that I'm doing, even though it is, to focus my ability. It's this private thing I'm doing to focus my ability so that when I'm in the world, I can carry that. So it's like being able to, so if you're playing the piano, you know, to be able to be so good and so familiar with the keys that even if you're walking and, you know, at the spur of the moment, somebody, all of a sudden there's, you're walking down the street and all of a sudden there's a piano and you can just walk up to the piano and start playing something amazing because you're just in the flow of the piano. So same thing with the meditation. You maintain that observer. You maintain that awareness and bring it to whatever situation you're into. So whether you're doing a formal meditation practice or you're taking a few moments, you know, in the beginning of your day, you know, to just gaze out the window and just observe what you see. You know, maybe reflect upon that. You know, what does that movement of that bird, you know, just letting your mind go to the point where, oh my gosh, you know, I was just looking for something, you know, and that bird is looking for something. And whatever the themes or rhythms or, you can call them coincidences, but I tend to use the word synergistic occurrences. Italian say simpatico, you know, the things that just flow and they just feel right. Serendipity. There's a lot of good words for that. So meditation is not, it's not in this little tight box. You know, it's very much can be and is intended to be a free flowing presence. Whether we do that through a formal Zen practice,